Hey guys, Sean here. Today we're going to be looking at the new Game Boy camera. And when I say new, I mean it's the old Game Boy camera, but it's a new PCB and it runs custom software. And let's take a look.
Okay, so this is an original Game Boy camera, as you guys I'm sure know. This is a Japanese version. And for this mod, you can use the Japanese version, you can use the American version, whichever version, it doesn't really matter. You can see the Japanese version's in Japanese, but. Oh yeah, there's actually some pictures on here still. Some little Japanese kid, old PC, an old Japanese house. Those screens for they have for walls. Some funny old pictures. I should probably archive some of these pictures. It's kind of funny. It's mostly non-destructive, but there's going to be a couple of things that we need from this for this mod. We're going to be using a new PCB. That's this here. These were designed by Martin Revseth, or HDR as he's known online. You can go to his GitHub and you can order these directly through the sponsor of today's video, PCB Way. Okay, so this is the GitHub project from HDR for the Game Boy camera, the new PCB. And you just scroll right down here and it says purchase on PCB Way. So you click that. It takes you right to the PCB website where you can just add it to your cart. And just like that, everything's ready to go. You want to use pretty much all of these settings are should be accurate. I think the only one that you want to change is this one here. You want to make sure you use Immersion Gold, and that should be it. For five boards, the total is about $45. The pretty quick turnaround from PCBWay. And then that's it. PCBWay is really good about anything you add to your cart. They will actually themselves analyze it, and they'll contact you and ask if they have any questions about like what it is your project is, and they'll really help you figure out what it is you need. But that's all you need to do. You just add it to your cart and you wait for them to approve it, and then you purchase it and you're good to go. So after you order the PCBs, this is what you'll get in the mail. This is just a blank, bare PCB. And then Martin has all of the components you need. It's called the BOM, the Bill of Materials. And that's what all this stuff is here. You can get all this stuff at like LCSC, Arrow, DigiKey. There's a bunch of different websites where you can get all these components. And they're all just little capacitors, resistors, various connectors and things. And there's a couple things. I think there's two components that we're going to need from the Game Boy camera. So let's put this stuff aside, put it there, and let's take a look inside the Game Boy camera. Okay, so this part just comes right off. So the two main components we need are, I guess there's some kind of diode. The diode is going to end up going here. I'm not quite sure where that is on this yet, but we do need this chip here. So we need a diode, this chip, and this connector here, which connects the PCB to the camera module. We can either reuse that, or they do actually sell these, and you can even get longer ones, so you can do different types of mods if you want to, like orient this somewhere else, for example. Let's see. Okay, so this whole thing just comes right out like this. 1998. Okay, just like that. So there's the PCB. Let me just check Martin's GitHub. Yeah, the diode says Harvest D2 from the original cartridge right here. D2, and there's the diode. So a diode, if you don't know, it restricts the current of a circuit so that it can only flow in one direction and it can't go the other way. So anyway, we need that diode there, and we need this big chip here. Okay, so the way I'm going to remove this chip is with hot air. There's a lot of other small components all around. So what I might recommend in a case like this is using some Kapton tape. I'm just going to hold it there for a second. I'm going to switch to tweezers because I'm going to have to grab it somehow. I'm not applying any sort of twisting motion or anything like that. I want it to break away very naturally. And just like that. There we go. The chip is desoldered. And you want to be careful of this battery, not to heat up the battery too much, but. So I'm going to hold it in place, keep gently testing to see if it's come free or not yet. It's almost there, and there we go. If you have an iPhone, you can set it to this kind of mode where you can zoom in and out. Let me lower the brightness a little bit here so you can see what's going on. It's basically like having a microscope. You can see these very, very small components much more clearly than you can see with your eye. So just get out your can of New Coke, set your phone on top of that, just like this. And you can solder around it like this while looking at all the components. You can even turn on a flashlight. Sometimes it helps. Okay, so what I like to do is add flux and a little bit of solder to all of the pins that we're going to be soldering to. Heat this up so it, you know, melts all over the pins. You're not going to need very much here. Just add a little bit and kind of drag it across. So here is the chip. An even better way to do this would be with a hot plate and solder paste, but that will definitely be for a future video. And you just basically just have to do your best to line this up. You don't want to do all of it. I'm just going to put my finger here and tack down one corner. That, get it to flow. And then maybe tack down like the opposite corner. Okay. So that chip should hopefully be tacked down now. I am going to just visually look at this just to make sure. Just go around and kind of draw your soldering iron across each pin. It looks shiny right there, but I think that's just flux that's being shiny. It's not actual solder. Need a bit more touch up. Okay, so a lot has happened. I finished soldering everything to the board. I went over it very thoroughly with like a little loop. I pretty much got it working. I put it in my Game Boy and it was actually functional and taking pictures. But then I noticed like it was kind of having some really weird glitches and not really saving the pictures properly. And then occasionally it would just like erase all the pictures and it was having all kinds of issues, so I went over it again. Eventually I went on the Game Boy Camera Club Discord, and they helped me quite a bit. I spent like two entire full days trying to get this one camera working, and I kind of gave up. I just could not get it working. So I went out and I bought a second Game Boy camera because I had more parts to build more because I got five boards. So I also bought a hot plate and some solder paste. So I decided to go the route of using a hot plate. And well, that time it definitely worked. And I do think that it worked better, but I didn't have a solder paste stencil for the PCBs. I didn't order one with the PCBs. So I just applied all the solder paste by hand, and some of those little pads are incredibly tiny.
So, some parts had too much solder, some parts didn't have enough. And I had to go back in and clean up some like bridges and things, and it just wasn't working for me. So at that point, I actually gave up on this entire project. I wasn't gonna even post this video. And then I mentioned it, something on the Discord, and people, they felt bad and they felt sorry, and they continued to try and help me. But I was like, I think I've spent like hundreds of dollars on this and so much time, and it's like I just have to move on to another project. But then one guy reached out to me. His name was Christopher. Very, very nice. He's helped lots of people in the Discord. He said, if I send him my two cameras that I tried to put together, he'll take a look and see if he can fix them for me. And so I did that, and he did. He repaired both of them. So I guess my soldering skills are just not quite up to par yet. But yeah, really, from the bottom of my heart, thank you, Christopher, for helping me get these cameras working. I'm gonna put a link in the description to his Instagram. You guys can follow him. But yeah, it's been a very long process. This is not an easy mod. The little 0402 sized capacitors are pretty difficult. But I do think that the part that I had the most difficulty with was soldering the Mac GBD, the main chip from the Game Boy camera. There's just pins on all four sides, and they're very small. And for some reason, it was very, very difficult. No matter how much I went over it and how accurate I was, like I'm pretty accurate, and I was looking at through a loop, through a magnifying glass, through my iPhone magnifier, and it was just a very it is a difficult mod, to say the least. But I'm very grateful that I have two working cameras now. So I guess in the end, I haven't totally given up on this project, but I did require some assistance. So just putting that out there. I will probably try again. I have a couple more boards, so and components, so I probably will try again in the future to make another one on my own. But for now, I have two working ones, so let's go try them out and see what this new PCB can do. So on the PCB, there's actually a little switch, and each position can hold a ROM. So you can install one of several custom or even original camera softwares that are available. I guess it can also run games, which I'm not sure you'd want to do, but it's possible. But there's quite a few different camera softwares now. Two of the most popular ones are called, there's one called Pixlr, which is made by a guy named Herr Gack. That's his Instagram name. I think his name is Andreas Gack. And there's another one called Photo, which was made by Toxa. Of course, there's other ones too, like you can download like the Hello Kitty pocket camera one. But yeah, there's lots of fun things you can do with the different softwares. And some people are doing really incredible things, like multiple exposures to create like HDR photos. That really seems to make a big difference. So I guess that's mostly it for this one, you guys. I now have two functional Game Boy cameras. I think for one of them, what I want to do is take it out of this original shell and put it into the 2-bit toy camera shell where you can put a custom lens, but that'll be a separate video. And then eventually I want to take the other one and create Christopher Graves, the Game Boy camera on Instagram. He created a 3D printed a full looks like a DSLR for with like an actual Game Boy and Game Boy camera inside with custom lenses and everything. So that's definitely going to be a future project of mine. But yeah, for now I guess that's it for this one, and I'll see you guys next time.